filter out some of the background?
Dr. John Tisdale, a hematologist, has spent the last 2 decades searching for a cure for sickle cell disease.
There we go.
Part of the reason why I chose this disease for study was because I think patients with sickle cell disease don't really get good treatment.
It's a very different kind of pain.
It hurts. It hurts bad.
During my residency training, I had seen a lot of patients with sickle cell disease, and we had nothing to do for them. We had pain medication, but that was basically it. And it looked like a wide open space for research and really a big area of need.
In 2008, Dr. Tisdale designed a clinical trial that he hoped might someday lead to a cure for sickle cell.
But the mystery does still lie in the details. Many of the tools that have been created work well in a laboratory setting, but moving those tools from a laboratory setting through animal models into the human is a completely different story.
I'm going to ask you a few questions first.
After a lifetime of recurring pain, and now suffering from severe organ damage, Deidra Williams is eager to participate in Dr. Tisdale's protocol. At 39, the life expectancy for adults with sickle cell, she feels she has nothing to lose.
Tell me a little bit about your history with sickle cell disease.
I had a gallbladder removal. This eye hemorrhaged back here due to the popping and other cells. Calcified blood clot caused them to have to do a partial hysterectomy.
I see.
I've been in and out the hospital all my life. Sickle cell can cause devastating, life-threatening problems.
Within the last 5 years,
yes,
it got worse. I was having pain every day. No longer did I have my breaks.
By break, she means that her pain wasn't spiking to like a 9 or a 10.
But you still had pain.
She always had pain.
You always had pain.
Yeah, so.
The pain can last anywhere from an hour to several days to weeks, and it's excruciating.
As a husband, you want to provide for your spouse. And you want to protect them from anything that will harm them or hurt them. With sickle cell, you can't ease the pain. You can't take it away. It's one of the worst feelings in the world. Yeah. One of the worst feelings in the world.
I do fight the depression and the anxiety that goes along with the pain.
When you become just so chronically ill and broken down, you're not participating in life. And you don't tend to participate with your family members.
I need a good outcome with this study. You know, if anything, I just really wanted to be around for my children. It's very much life and death.
Turn in a full circle.
Perfect. You're good.
Building 10, the largest research hospital in the world.
Okay, Bo, that's it.
In many ways, is the beating heart of medical research.
All right.
Okay, so Anita, are you ready?
Ready.
I like to say this place is a place where science fiction can become reality.
Building 10, which for over half a century has been a place of hope for hundreds of thousands of patients, was born in the aftermath of war.
We're here today to lay the cornerstone of a building which will be devoted to the service of mankind.
In 1951, just 6 years after the devastation of World War II, President Harry Truman laid the cornerstone for Building 10. Setting forth a new and radical vision for medical research.
It will serve men of all religions, all races, and all nations everywhere in the world.
Truman envisioned Building 10 as a scientific sanctuary, a place where doctors would have the time and resources to find cures for modern medicine's greatest mysteries. And patients, in the hope of finding a treatment for what ailed them, would bravely help advance medical science.